On anticipated big days, a storm chaser might drive all the way to Iowa and only see some rain. Then turn around and drive all night back to Texas and only see some rain. A storm chaser might drive all the way to Montana only to get a sunburn. And sometimes a storm chaser isn't expecting to see anything, and they find a monster. April 11th, my rear security camera captured a developing tornado over the mountains in Oklahoma. By the time I found a clearing and got the good cameras rolling, it was gone.
Nice little whirl right there.
The following day, my front security cameras captured this tornado. By the time I got the good cameras rolling, it was gone.
Tornado right there.
Over the trees in Mississippi, anvil crawler lightning scampered like spiders. Over the storms later that night, falling stars seemed to cue the red sprites. Oh. And the red sprites always seem to cue the coyotes.
Dancing sprites.
Nice. Bam. Big sprite.
Got our first towers going up for the day. Those white clouds right there along the dry line are these right here. Time is 3:48.
On April 29th, an incredible EF3 would torment Andover, Kansas.
6:31, beautiful funnel cloud.
But I got to document this EF0, tormenting prairie dogs and flinging grasshoppers near Hope, Kansas.
Boom! Here comes the conga line.
Morning. Here's the plan for today. It's kind of like plugging in a USB cable. It's 50-50, you're gonna get it right. And I'm thinking I'm gonna go with the northern target because it's a lot less driving. And tomorrow I have to be right back up here in Oklahoma for the big day. Days with low risk of tornadoes can still offer beautiful storm scenery, without as many chasers crowding the best vantage points.
Hey, dude.
What?
How you doing?
I'm good. You're my shot. Can you move back a bit? Oh, you want that? I'm sorry. Sorry.
As this weak tornado passed overhead, a carousel of suction vortices was on the ground,
terrorizing prairie dogs and flinging grasshoppers. Though it was an active March and April, I wasn't able to wrangle any photogenic tornadoes. On May the 4th, my luck changed. Going back up. Extreme drought conditions in West Texas fed this highly visible storm red dust as it fostered multiple photogenic tornadoes over open country. Oh, that's cool. Later that evening, as the storm tapped into more moisture, conditions became much more dangerous. A large, rain-wrapped EF3 would impact the town of Lockett, Texas, and several chasers.
Hey, old dog. Hello.
Well, don't you think about it. Don't you think about it.
Some animals haven't learned the highway is a dangerous place. Some people haven't learned this either. Sometimes you try to teach them a helpful lesson. Sometimes that just ends up in road rage.
And it's super dusty atmosphere. You can't see much, so we're going to be relying heavily on radar.
The ongoing severe drought in Texas offered a unique look into tornado genesis.
There's a funnel cloud in there. Yep, there's the tornado warning.
The easily lofted dirt and dust reveals multiple weak vortices under the base prior to the large main tornado developing. And the slow storm motion enabled me to shoot long, stable time lapses of the process.
Creaky storm. Man. Ooh! That scared me.
That's 20.
right for us.
Here we are again, passing the tornado. It's the hail situation.
All right, we gotta go, Larry.
That's what I hate about getting too close.
Creepy shadow of this tornado. Radar revealed a second tornado was likely developing behind me.
It's doing a little U-turn. It's kind of stationary out there.
Concerned about the approaching large destructive hail and potentially being in a tornado sandwich, I made the daring call to slip south, at least out of this thing's path.
Oh, I'm shaking. Here comes the hail. Yeah, we gotta go this way. Otherwise the hail's gonna destroy us in the path of this thing.
This tornado retreating deeper into the hail core, I decided to bail and make a run for the new tornado. But it didn't take long for the storm to dump on those plans.
This is all inflow. This is all the storm pulling in all this dust. So that means it could tornado again. Not gonna be easy to see when you can only see 30 yards in front of you.
Very.
Okay. So there's a tornado in there. Tumbleweed!
Just jets of dust streaming in and you couldn't see, and there was hail crashing out and you couldn't see, and there was tumbleweed stampedes and there was lightning, and was able to get right in that sweet spot and see a nasty big old brown tornado. To celebrate, we're having sriracha tuna on saltine crackers with half the sodium, and for dessert we're going all out and having a big old can of pineapple. I almost didn't even come out today. I woke up at 5 a.m. and I did a forecast and I thought, ain't nothing gonna happen. And then I thought, what the heck, it's May. And out here in May, magic happens. Nasty brown burrito magic.
By the end of May, extensive road wear, isolation, and mental exhaustion can start to set in.
Don't fall over. Don't fall over. I've got to show you the awesome sound my bed makes. Ready? Watch this.
Thank you.
gonna make it sound. Papa gonna build a fence around. Mother Nature gonna blow the whole thing down.
You know, I charge for appearances.
You got a nickel coming to you.
From Texas to Montana, Florida to Arizona, for the rest of the year, I trail beautiful lightning storms over the endless miles. In 2022, 1,240 confirmed tornadoes have been tallied. I was only able to track down a dozen of those, my third consecutive year with below average scores. Though 2022 wasn't as epic as 2016 or 2019 for many of us, we'd be foolish to complain. Till next time, friends, happy trails.